How the Mighty Hath Fallen. On June 25th, 2021, Tereba released an article stating that they're changing how their free shipping practices are going to change for its customers effective June 30th, 2021. Essentially, we're going to be needing to start to pay for our shipping, which I don't exactly know how that's going to change my behavior in playing the game, but I do think I'm going to be playing it at a lesser extent. Now, before we continue, there is something that I wanted to share because I received it back in November 2020. Make sure to read your emails out there so you don't miss anything. I received some fan art! Look, it's me and Tokage, it's so cute! Thank you, Rion, for sending this to me. I hope if you're out there watching this video that you can also respond back to me so I can share your IG page or your DeviantArt page or whichever platform you use to display your artwork. I'd like to make sure that I give credit to you in the description below. So thank you so much, and you are neat. All right, so let's go ahead and take a deep dive and let me rant a little bit about these different shipping changes. So I do know that with COVID-19 and the worldwide pandemic and everything that's been going on, a lot of local businesses have actually closed down. And that's kind of the same for some of the online apps that I kind of looked in the past before. For example, Sega Catcher Online, I don't even think it's operational anymore, and I do realize that the functionality of different games that I've actually reviewed, they kind of went lower in quality. So I'm not surprised that Tereba's doing something to kind of alleviate costs or recover some funds that they may have lost throughout the entire last year, but I will say that I'm a little sad that this is something that's happening. So yeah, I guess there's not much that we can do, but let's go ahead and just break down to see what kind of different things that they're going to be changing here. Looking into this, there are two things to take away from here. First, they are separating prizes into two different categories based on how they are won. So, paid prize acquisitions are anything that is won with TP, and free prize acquisitions are those won with free play tickets and tutorial tickets. Okay, so that's a little self-explanatory, so let's go ahead and talk about their new shipping practices. So, looking at this chart, I think it's pretty self-explanatory. Basically, if you spent at least 50,000 TP, which is $50 USD, within a period of 1 month, you're eligible to ship anything for free. Kind of as if nothing has changed if you're a paying player. However, if you haven't spent the $50 in a month's time, then free acquisition prizes or add-on prizes will need to be paid for. And kind of like how their shipping is already stated, depending on the weight of the package, you're basically looking at a minimum of $20 USD, and you know it can raise up from there. I think the best way to summarize this is if you've spent $50 in the last month and something in your cart happens to be paid for using TP, then you'll be eligible for free shipping. Otherwise, you're gonna have to pay. Now, I saw that they also included TapJoy options or surveys that give out TP, so I'm not sure if that's included, but that's also something to take note of. Honestly, I think it's pretty fair, right? So for people who are actually paying for the game, there's a possibility that they're actually reaching $50 on a monthly basis, so it's a little bit easier for them to kind of experience this and it's gonna be like nothing happened. But for people who are doing strictly free-to-play or mostly free-to-play, it changes pretty drastically because they're asking you to basically spend $50 a month. It can get pretty hefty, particularly if you're able to even break even at that point, because in order to reach $50, you're looking at maybe winning 2 to 3 medium to large size prizes, or you're looking to win 4 to 5 smaller prizes. And that's actually if you can even win those things. Like I've read on Reddit and some of the comments on my channel that Tereba is getting a little bit more difficult to win, you know? Like the setups are a little bit more difficult, there's alleged tape on the rods so things don't really fall as easily, or just the general strength of the claw is, you know, not as strong as it used to be. So I can understand why it's a little frustrating when you're trying to win stuff and get your money's worth, but now they're also asking us to do these $50 just to get free shipping on top of it. I think the cool thing about Tereba was the potential of winning these higher quality prizes for a little bit cheaper than what you would do at retail, right? And I think that's kind of the draw of Crane games in general, where you're playing this thing, you only spend like a dollar or something like that to win a $30 prize. So for people who are really good at these Crane games, they only do free to play, or you know, they don't really think too much about spending, they probably do profit a lot just winning these different prizes, but now with the addition of shipping, it kind of goes into that argument about, well, why don't you just buy the prize instead of just going through this process of maybe spending a lot of money to win it? Now, I know that in a previous video, I talked about how much I'm actually spending based on how much I actually win, and it kind of boiled down to me just basically spending a little bit less than retail, but not needing to pay for shipping. So with the additional shipping costs, it's kind of like, Well, now that I'm not really thinking too much about just the experience of playing the crane games and strategizing and doing, you know, some of these analyzing videos, now it's just kind of like, well, maybe it is better to just buy the product as opposed to like playing a crane game that's a little bit more difficult to play now, and then I have to play with shipping on top of it. So I can see why that this kind of change might make them lose a lot of users. So it's a really interesting thing that they're doing it this way. The one thing that I do find intriguing though is that the statement about the memberships and that they are not going to be calculated in the 50,000 TP threshold. Like, even though I don't personally subscribe to these memberships, I find it odd that they would require additional money from people who are already paying. It's like these people are loyally giving you funds and now it's like, well, all the free people are taking an advantage, so we'll punish everybody else for it. I mean, shipping costs aside, it's actually pretty expensive. That's typically how things tend to work out, right? Although, looking at their memberships, they should probably reevaluate how they are managing these things, considering the new shipping changes that they're trying to implement. Paying members are already a little bit cheaper. It's about $3 for 10,000 TP. They could easily just raise this price to $5, or maybe making separate tiers with higher prices, and then those different tiers could include free shipping to alleviate some of the cost for those who are already paying members and just slap on additional TP. Something like a $50 platinum tier membership with a bunch of cool free stuff, exclusives, and free items, which some people would probably be okay with. I mean, look, the only thing that you're getting for signing up for a membership is just additional TP. Not only would people already be paying the $50 they're asking to qualify for free shipping, but they'd feel excited to do so with the additional exclusive content. There's a lot of different ways that Tareba probably could have approached this. I mean, I don't run a business, so I don't know how to do any type of business analytics, but from the user perspective, I'd like to at least think that, you know, it's all about making the customers more satisfied with the product that they're getting, or see that there's actually logic behind the way that they're doing things. Like, you can't just go cold turkey and be like, free shipping, and then all of a sudden, no free shipping. Like, there should be some kind of gradual change in it that makes sense, right? But, you know, what do I know? I'm just a user. I've been playing Tareba for quite some time. So I don't even know if I would be comfortable going into a paid, the membership that I even proposed, because I've experienced Tareba in its glory days, you know, where they gave a lot of cool free stuff and prizes were really easy to win and there was always gonna be free shipping. So I don't know. I think at the end of the day, really the question is, are you still going to keep on playing?